Hello my dear students, welcome back to the video lesson. I am Shweta Gupta, your maths teacher, and today I am going to teach you exercise 4C of lesson number 4, and the topic of the lesson is operation with large numbers. And in this exercise we will do the operations with large numbers related to multiplication and division. So let's get started. Children, we do multiplication and division of large numbers in the same way as we do the multiplication and division of small numbers. So let's learn how to do the multiplication and division of large numbers in this exercise, that is exercise 4C. So now children, let's start exercise 4C. First we will do the multiplication of large numbers. So we will begin with question number 2, C part. Here we have a large number 1,54,089 which we have to multiply by 65. So let's see how we will do the multiplication. In 65 children, 5 is at 1's place and 6 is at 10's place. So we will start the multiplication by the digit at 1's place, which is 5. So 5 9's are 45, so we will write 5. And 4 will be carried to the next place. At next place we have 8, so 5 8's are 40. 40 plus 4, 44. So we will write 4. And again 4 will be carried to the next place. 5 0's are 0, 0 plus 4, 4. We will write 4. And again 5 4's are 20, so we will write 0. And 2 will be carried to the next place. At the next place we have 5, so 5 5's are 25, 25 plus 2, 27. So we will write 7. And 2 will be carried to the next place. At the next place we have 1, so 5 1's are 5 plus 2, which is equal to 7. Now children, we will move to the 10's place, and at the 10's place we have 6. So we will multiply this large number by 6. And since 6 is at 10's place, so we will start the multiplication from the 10's place. So now 6 9's are 54. So we will write 4 at 10's place. And we will leave the 1's place. Now 5 will be carried to the next place. And at next place we have 8. So we will multiply 6 by 8. 6 8's are 48, 48 plus 5, 53, so we will write 3, and 5 will be carried to the next place. 6 0's are 0, 0 plus 5, 5, so we will write 5, and 6 4's are 24, so we will write 4, and children, now 6 5's are 30, and 2 will be carried from the previous place. So 30 plus 2, 32, so we will write 2, and 3 will be carried to the next place. And at the next place we have 1, so 6 1's are 6, and 6 plus 3, 9, so we will write 9. Now children, we are going to add these two numbers that we got by multiplication. So 5, 4 plus 4, 8, 4 plus 3, 7, 0 plus 5, 5, 7 plus 4, 11, 1 carried to the next place. 7 plus 2 plus 1, 10. 1 carry to the next place and 9 plus 1, 10. So this is the product of our multiplication, or we can say this is our answer. Now children, let's do the next question, which is C part of question number 3. So here we have to multiply 20541 by 350. Okay, so let's see how we are going to multiply. Now in this question children, we have to multiply 20,541 by 350. And 350 is a 3-digit number. Okay, so we will start from the digit at the ones place, which is 0. So start multiplying 20,541 by 0. So when we multiply 20,541 by 0, we will get 0. And now we will move to the next digit, which is 5, at the tens place. So we will start the multiplication of 20,541 by 5. And since 5 is a tens place, so we will start the multiplication in the next step from the tens place. And we will leave the ones place empty. So 5 ones are 5. We will write 5. Then 5 fours are 20, so we will write 0. And 2 will be carried to the next place. 5 fives are 25. 25 plus 2, 27. So we will write 7. And again 2 will be carried to the next place. 5 zeros are 0. 0 plus 2, 2. And 5 twos are 10. So we will write 10. Now children, in 350, now the digit at the 100 place is 3. So we will multiply 20541 by 3. And since 3 is at 100 place, so in the next step, the multiplication will start from the 100 place. And the ones place and tens place will remain empty. So 3 ones are 3. We will write 3 at 100 place. 3 fours are 12. So we will write 2. And 1 will be carried to the next place. 3 fives are 15. 15 plus 1, 16. So we will write 6. And children, 3 zeros are 0. So 0 plus 1, 1. And 3 twos are 6. Now we are going to add these 3 products. So 0, 0 plus 5, 5, 0 plus 0 plus 3, 3, 0 plus 7 plus 2, 9, 0 plus 2 plus 6, 8, 0 plus 1, 1, and 1 plus 6, 7. So children, this is the product of our multiplication, or we can say this is the answer. Now children, let's do question number 4, B part. So here children, we are multiplying 1275 by 4093. Now children, here we are multiplying by a number which is having 4 digits. And again children, we will start the multiplication from the digit at ones place, which is 3 in 4093. So let's start the multiplication by dividing 1275 by 3. So 3 fives are 15. We will write 5, and 1 will be carried to the next place. 3 sevens are 21. 21 plus 1, 22. So we will write 2, and 2 will be carried to the next place. 3 twos are 6. 6 plus 2, 8. So we will write 8. And children, 3 ones are 3. So we will write 3. Now children, we will move to the next digit, which is the digit at tens place, which is 9. So we will start multiplying 1275 by 9. And since 9 is a tens place, so in the next step, we will start the multiplication from the tens place. So 9 fives are 45. We will write 5 at tens place. And 4 will be carried to the next place. And 9 sevens are 63. 63 plus 4, 67. We will write 7. And 6 will be carried to the next place where we have 2. So 9 twos are 18. 18 plus 6, 24. We will write 4. And 2 will be carried to the next place. And 9 ones are 9. 9 plus 2, 11. So we will write 11. Now children, we will move to the next digit, which is the digit at the 100 place. And this is 0. So now we will multiply 1275 by 0. And this multiplication we will start from the 100 place. And since when we multiply any number by 0, we get the answer 0. So what is our answer? 0. Right? And we have started this multiplication from the 100 place. Now children, we will move to the next digit in 4093, which is 4, and which is at 1000 place. So we will begin the multiplication from the 1000 place. So 4 sevens are, 4 fives are 20. So we will write 0 at 1000 place. And we will leave the ones, tens and 100 place empty. Now since 4 fives are 20, so we have written 0 and 2 will be carried to the next place. Now 4 sevens are 28, 28 plus 2, 30. So we will write 0 and 3 will be carried to the next place. 4 twos are 8, 8 plus 3, 11. So we will write 1 and 1 will be carried to the next place. 4 ones are 4 plus 1, 5. So we will write 5. Now we are going to add these 4 products. So 5 at 1's place, 5 plus 2, 7 at 10's place, 8 plus 7, 15. So we will write 5 and 1 will be carried to the next place. And at the next place we have 3 plus 4, 7 plus 1, it is 8. 1 plus 0, 1. 1 plus 0 plus 1, 2. And 5. So 5, 2, 1, 8, 5, 7, 5 is the product of our multiplication. Now children, let's do division of the large numbers. So first we will do the C part of question number 7. Here we have to divide the large number 92184 by 46. Children, what does it mean? It means that 46 is the divisor and 92184 or 92184 is the dividend. So now let's start the division. So now children, you know that in the divisor 46 there are two digits. So in the dividend also, first we will take two digits, that is 9 and 2, and the number formed by 9 and 2 is 92. And so now we will divide 92 by 46. So we know that 46 twos are 92. So we will write 92 and in the quotient place we will write 2. And now 92 subtracted from 92 is equal to 0. And now children, in the next step we will carry 1. We will carry down 1. And now can we divide 1 by 46? No, we cannot divide. So we have to write 0 in the quotient place, and then we will carry down 8. And now we have the number 18, but still 18 is less than 46, so we cannot divide 18 by 46. So again we have to write 0 at the quotient place. So now children, we will carry the next digit, which is 4, we will carry it down, and now what is the number form? It is 184. So now children, 184 is bigger than 46, so it can be easily divided by 46. So when we divide 184 by 46, what do we get? We get 4 as the quotient, and 184 subtracted from 184 gives 0 as the remainder. So we can say that our quotient is equal to 2004. So this is the answer. So now children, let's move to the next question on division of large numbers, which is question number 9C part. So here we have to divide 31,284 by 216. So now 216 is the divisor and 31,284 is the dividend. So now children, let's begin the division. Now children, we know that there are 3 digits in the divisor. So first we will take 3 digits in the dividend also, that is 312. And we will see whether the number formed by these 3 digits, 312, which is 312. And we will try to divide 312 by 216. So when we divide 312 by 216, what do we get? 216 ones are 216, and so we will write 216. And now let's subtract 216 from 312. So what do we get? We get 96. Now we will carry one digit down, which is 8. So we get the number 968. So now we will divide 968 by 216. So 216 multiplied by 4 is equal to, it is equal to 864, right? So we will write 864, and then we will subtract 864 from 968, right? So what do we get as remainder? We get 104. Now children, now we will carry down the last digit, which is 4. And what is the number that is formed? It is 1044 or 1044. Now children, we will divide 1044 by 260. So again, 216 fours are 864. So we will write 4 in the quotient, and 864 we will write here, and then we will subtract it from 1044. And what do we get? We get 180. Now children, we don't have any other digit to carry down, so we have to stop the division here. And so 180 is the remainder, and 144 is the quotient. So this is the answer of our division. Now children, let's do one more sum on division of large number, which is we part of question number 10. So in this question we have the large number, which is 2,15,798 divided by 250. So let's see how we are going to divide. Now children, in the divisor we have 215 and in the dividend we have 2,15,798. Now since divisor has 3 digits, so first of all we will take 3 digits in the dividend, and since 215 is equal to 215, so it can be easily divided by 215. So when 215 divided by 215 gives 1 as quotient. So we will write 1 in the quotient part and 215 here. So now we will subtract 215 from 215 and we get 0 as remainder. Now we will carry 7 in the next step. But now we cannot divide 7 by 215 because 7 is less than 215. So we have to write 0 in the quotient and we will carry down another digit, which is 9. But the number formed by 9 is 79, which is again less than 215. So again we have to write 0 in the quotient, and next we will carry the next digit, which is 8. So it will be carried down, and now the number formed is 798. So we will divide 798, which is more than 215, by 215, right? So when we divide 798 by 215, what do we get? We get 3 as the quotient, and we will write 645 below 798, and we will subtract 645 by 798, and we get 153. So this is the remainder, because now there are no other digit to carry down for further division. So this is the remainder of our division, and 1003 is the quotient. So we will write quotient is equal to 1003 and remainder is equal to 153. So this way we have completed the division of this large number. Children, I hope you have very well understood how to do the multiplication and division of large numbers. Now children, this is your home assignment in which you have to do some questions on multiplication and some question on division of large numbers, right? And this home assignment you will do in your maths homework copy in a very neat and clean handwriting. This way we have come to the end of our video lesson. I hope you have enjoyed it thoroughly. Thank you, my dear students. Keep watching, keep learning.